Hi guys, it's Adam and welcome to the Super Secret Mystery Box Haul. So I've decided to show you 50% of the items I was going to show you and basically that's just due to time factor. Unfortunately, however much I would like to, I can't sit in front of a camera for 2 hours and do a haul video. It just doesn't demand my time. But I can stand in front of a camera and maybe do it for half an hour. So we'll see how this goes. I'll show you what I've got to show you. And some of the stuff I've excluded, you've either already seen before, or some of it's that I don't want to share, and others just like bits and bobs that aren't really that great anyway. So I've cherry picked a lot of the shipment and I'm going to show you sort of the better bits. So yeah, without further ado, I shall get on with it. So I got... it's worth noting as well, all the wires for the consoles I've not brought down, just because I didn't want to be going up and down, just to show you the wires. There's no point in me bringing down like tons of wires. So I got two PS1s, not audiophile, but as you can see it has a parallel port, if that means anything, I don't know. But yeah, two of these I got. The other one, is it in here or is it upstairs? Let's have a look. No, that's all. Must be upstairs, the other one. I must have not brought it down. Great. Everything's going to pot. Two of these, and I got a PS1 Slim. If you can see that, light's a bit off, but here you go. And a PS2 Slim, which is also upstairs, I've just remembered, but really I needed to bring that down. Also included in the job lot was a couple of weird, you know, like, not weird, but just crappy PS1 games, and five pads, two PS1, but not the analog pads, and three PS2. And I got that job lot for £55, so I'm fairly pleased with that price. I mean, like, your PS1 with your wires and that, probably looking about £30 on FBA, something around there. And I've got two of them, obviously. With the crappy games, bundle them up. It's not far off my money back. And then I've got the pads, and then I've got the PS1 Slim, and I've got the PS2 Slim. So, yeah, I'm fairly happy with that. Not an amazing amount of profit in that, but, you know, at least a little bit. So yeah, next one is a NES console, a Nintendo Entertainment System. I really like testing this. I had a bit of trouble at first with testing it, but I did contact David McGregor and he helped me out, so thanks David. And yeah, I really enjoyed testing this actually. I paid a little bit more than I would have liked to, but I sort of really wanted to get this console, because I've never had it before and I really wanted it. So I paid £80 for that. Now, that isn't just for that, there are games with it. I got two controllers and all the wires for it. Now, I think I could probably get about £120 for the console, the controllers and the wires on FBA. So yeah, it's probably like about my money back, that sort of area, maybe even a little bit of profit there on the console. Then I got with it, there are some games upstairs, but the games upstairs are Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which is like a £10 cart. Track and Field 2, which again isn't great. Probotector, which is like a £20 cart. Well, it would be a bit more, but I've got it listed for £20 because the label's damaged. And then I got Wild Gunman, which again is like £20-25 cart. Two editions of Super Mario Bros. 3 in there, and they're like £20 each. And then Super Mario Bros. Or Super Mario Bros. Duck Hunt, or Super Mario Bros. / Duck Hunt, maybe that's the right way of saying it, but yeah. On FBA this is like £13. Now some of those games I'll be putting on eBay. I think I might put this one on eBay for a tenner or something like that. So yeah, I'm pleased with that. You know, there's profit in it, but it was more like a a purchase that was ruled a little bit more by my heart instead of my head. But yeah, I am happy with that, and there's still profit in it, so, and I had a great time testing it. Next, we have Crash Bandicoot, Big Box Edition. Is that, oh no, that's okay, I thought it was cracked there or something then. Yeah, Big Box Edition. I paid £15, well, £18 delivered for this, and I should quite easily get 60 quid back for that on Amazon FBA. I could probably push 70 quid, but yeah, 60 quid, and I'll get that within, I don't know, something, it's not, I don't know about time scale actually, but it's not going to be a real slow seller for that price, so yeah, happy with that. I got a, ooh, this was nice, now this was a good profitable item. So I got this for £45. It also came with a game I'm going to show, well, a few games, but I've already sent them off to FBA, but there is one still here. So this is a Nintendo 3DS, I believe it's the wine red colour. You know, nice condition. It came with its charger, I believe, but I don't know whether I've actually got it in there. And it came with this sort of nice case, well, you know, standard case, but I think it's pretty cool. And I paid £45 for that. Now, on Amazon Merchant Fulfilled, this is go. I know, also I wanted to highlight out there, that it's got some sort of, don't know whether it's scratching or wear or whatever it is, but I think a bit of it might rub out or might be able to get rid of it now I've come to look at it. But yeah. That is going Merchant Fulfilled, if I can even get my words out. Merchant Fulfilled for £113 as of like a couple of days ago when I last checked. So yeah, I could probably get, I don't know, like £130, £140 for that, something like that. I mean, some people may say you may as well push £150, but I don't know. But yeah, certainly good money in that anyway. So yeah, happy with that. No FBA offers as well, so that was pretty cool. The game that I got with it as well for the £45, and there was another couple of games, but I forgot what they were. They've already gone into FBA, but they weren't particularly great. Mario Kart DS, about a £25 game. Does it have it? So yeah, it does. Has all of its inserts, manuals in there, which is really cool. So yeah, that was a great purchase. That was really, really good. I was really happy with that. Because even if I can only get 100 for it, I mean, that's still great. So yeah, what else? Harvest Moon DS. I got this in a charity shop for £3.99. I don't know, 20 quid, maybe 25 at a push, but they're going new for 30, so I'd say 20. That's that one. I paid £15. Who's that? Oh, it's alright. I paid £15 for this black Nintendo DS. Just DS Lite, nothing special, you know, not like the DSi or 3DS. But yeah, I paid £15 for that. Another edition of Mario Kart and a couple of, or maybe even like four kart-only games. I think I'll get like, what, 40 or 50 back for that on FBA. If I'm wrong, I'll correct myself up there, but I think that's about right. Mario Kart is already sent up there actually, because I got this quite a while back, but I've just not sent it in, and that obviously that's up there for like 2025, so yeah, happy with that one. Obviously I'll clear my money back in, basically in Mario Kart, and then that's profit, or I'll clear my money back in that, and then Mario Kart's profit, but yeah, and then there's a few other little crappy sort of games. Right, what else? We'll do them in a minute. £3.99 I paid for this. I can't remember what this is going for either. I don't know whether I paid too much for that, to be fair. I thought I paid £1.99 for that. Yeah, I don't know, but I'll check what it's going for and then put it up there. I don't know. Anyway, I don't know. I forget where I get these things from or how much I paid and all this sort of stuff. Simpsons Monopoly, brand new and sealed. I paid 33 quid for this, delivered, and people are probably shouting at the screen now, what the hell, are you mad? Well, yeah, I am slightly mad, but you have to be a little bit like that to be a reseller anyway. I might keep this a little bit, like keep this here for a little bit. I don't know. I have shoved it in an FBA box. That's what I do. And then I work through the FBA boxes and think like, yeah, I will send that in. No, I won't send that in. So yeah, anyway, 33 quid for this. 100 quid, something like that, I'd probably get for it. £69.90 it was going for merchant fulfilled. So yeah, 100 quid. I could get more than that at Christmas. So that's what I'm saying. I'm thinking, should I just hold it back for a bit and then shoot it up there at Christmas time for like 120, something like that. So yeah, happy with that one anyway. Nice purchase. I got a crossword jigsaw, again from a charity shop, £2.99 into about 19 quid. Nothing too special. I forgot what this one's going for, but I believe I could get like FBA. I don't think there was any FBA offers when I researched it, when I was buying it. But I believe I could get like 30 or 40 for this. And I paid £4.99 in a British Heart Foundation. I don't usually buy anything from those places. So, yeah, pretty cool. Golden Girls. Yeah, pretty standard. I think I paid £1.50 for it. And I think it's going for like 10 to 12, something around there. So yeah, nothing amazing, but you know, it's okay. Right then. Oh, yeah. We'll do the GameCube. I forgot, I nearly left those out actually there. GameCube. £12.99 I paid. I don't know whether you're going to be able to see it, but that's... No, you're not going to be able to see that. God, that's weird. Yeah, £12.99 I paid. It came with an unofficial controller and the wires. I don't know what these are currently going for, because I've only ever had one GameCube in. But I would imagine, like, with the wires, but excluding the controller, 30 to 40 on FBA, something like that. I did check a while back, but yeah. Something along those lines. If I include the unofficial controller, maybe a bit more. But I don't really want to send it in with the unofficial controller to FBA. Maybe I'm just being paranoid, but I just like everything to be official. So yeah, anyway. So that's that. The reason I got that, I actually found that in a charity shop. A few days after I'd bought some GameCube games. And I thought, hang on a minute, how am I going to test these? I need to get a GameCube in. And I was saying to my mum, we were outsourcing, and I was saying, oh, we need to go to the charity shop over in this place. Now, I'm not going to say the name of the place, because it's a honey hole for me. So, and I know with local resellers who watch it, and they're like, oh, yeah, I'll go there. Yeah, yeah, I didn't know about that one. So, I'm not going to say the name of the place, but I go to this honey hole. It's quite nice. I usually get a few electronics, all that sort of stuff. And I was saying to my mum, oh God, I wish they have a GameCube in, because I really need a GameCube. Lo and behold, a GameCube was in with the wires, so happy with that. Now these are the GameCube games I got, and I paid 40 quid all in. It was £35, but then she said she wants a fiver extra for postage, so that one's nothing, that's like bundle fodder really. I might be able to get some money back on eBay, I don't know, but on FBA, it's nothing. We've got Pokemon Colosseum, probably £40 to £50 game, with the memory card 59. We've got Soul Calibur 2. These have all been tested, work fine. That's about a £10 game. Spyro, Enter the Dragonfly, maybe 40 quid, something like that on that one. Pokemon Colosseum, this is with the Pokemon box as well. Don't know whether I'm going to send that into FBA, so I don't really know a price on that. Maybe on eBay, I'll get some money back on eBay because, you know, it's Pokemon, but, you know, I don't know. I don't know price. Maybe 20 quid, maybe close to 30, I don't know. But something like that on that one. And then finally, Crash Bandicoot, Wrath of Cortex on the GameCube. Yeah, about sort of 40 to 50 on that one. So I did really well out of that little investment. I mean, from 40 quid to well over 100 anyway. So happy with that one. And you know, it's not much work. I often talk about this time to profit ratio or effort to profit ratio. And that is very little effort for some good money. So, you know, I mean, that took me not very long at all to test. It's not going to take me very long at all to list. and I don't know what my net on that's going to be, but I imagine it's going to be over 50 quid. So yeah, happy with that, can't complain. So that's those. Oh, one of those has fell. I have, from a charity shop, 249 New and Sealed Dungeons and Dragons. I think it's a DVD box set. Yeah, looking at sort of 70 to 80 quid on FBA for that one, so can't complain there. A little bit of wear to the corners, so yeah, I might have to see with that one. I might have to put it as like new, maybe decrease the price slightly, but at 249 I'm well in profit on that one. I have a geography puzzle, picked these up before, new and sealed, but well worth picking up. On Amazon FBA, looking about 20 quid, and I paid £2, so happy with that one. Got some trolley bags there. £3 paid on that one, looking about 15 quid. This is like all the new and sealed stuff we're getting into now. £3.99 on that one, and that was going for £27.99. Seal's a little bit loose, but yeah, there's no like sticker residue or anything to it, so that's alright. I paid around the £10 for this. I couldn't tell you exactly, but it's going for around the £30. I'll put exact figures up there for you, so you know you can just have a look for yourselves. But yeah, happy with that one as well. Nothing amazing, that's just sort of like bread and butter stuff. And I'm trying to get into those, like, increasing my bread and butter range. Now again, I paid around the tenner for this. It was just over a tenner, about 12 quid. But for the life of me, I can't remember what it goes for, so I'll put it up there. But yeah, I think there's still some good profit in it. I think it would have been over 20 quid if I paid a 12 quid for it. Got this here. Now I've got Pokemon Limited Edition Game Boy Color. And I thought it was really cool. Just to show you this as well, point this out. Pikachu's cheek lights up red when you turn it on. So I thought that was really cool. Now, I paid 40 quid for this with a couple of other Game Boy carts that are already listed on eBay for around a tenner. And this itself, maybe 100 quid on Amazon FBA, something like that. I know that Jamie picked one up over on Fate Rachel channel, and he said he was going to shoot for 120. I might do that. I mean, it's fairly good condition. It's got the original battery cover, so yeah, I might do that, but I don't know. Yeah, 100, 120. I could probably comfortably get 100, so anyway, that's alright. Not too bad at all. I'd like to shoot for 120, just because, you know, it's a bit of extra profit there. So I might shoot for 120 on that. I got this guy. Now, this is what I've really wanted to show you guys this, but now, I'm showing it to you now, and I've completely forgot. One, what I paid for it, and one, what it's going for. Now, this surprised me. This is one of those items that if you wanted to, and now I'm revealing the secrets. This is the secrets of eBay sniping here. There are a lot of items that people don't realise that you can actually buy on eBay to flip back onto FBA. Not a lot of people do it because they're like, well, I can get it at the boot sale, get it at charity shops, get it here, get it there, and I'll find it for like a quid or two. But what I like to do is cut all that effort out, buy it for like 30 quid. I think I paid like 30 or 40 for this. And I'm going to get some good money back on this. As I say, I can't quite remember, but like merchant fulfilled price on this was crazy. It was like 80 odd quid. So really, really happy with this. It was a great rank as well. But it's a good way of just buying things, flipping them. You get a higher value item. This is now a higher value item I've got. I can flip it on, you know, fairly quickly. I don't know whether I'm going to, again, like the Simpsons Monopoly, I don't know whether I'm going to wait to send it up until fourth quarter. But it's, you know, minimal effort. Obviously, I'm paying up for it. But I'm still going to get a fantastic profit on it. So I will put the amount on, you know, what it's going for on Amazon up there, or what I believe I can get for it. But yeah, that was a really good rank in toys as well. So I was really happy with that. And that came the other day. What else have we got? Right, we are down to the last few bits and bobs. We are down to a few other PS1 games. We have Crash Bandicoot 2, Cortex Strikes Back. I got this for £15 in a job lot. It was a very small job lot. I got this. Does this have its manual? Let me just check for you. Yes, it does. It looked like it didn't have its manual then. I got this with Grand Theft Auto, yeah, just the number one on PS1. I got a few other lower value titles. And this goes for like, I think this goes for like 35 FPA, something like that. If I'm wrong, I'll put it in the corner as usual. But yeah, I'm happy with that because Grand Theft Auto, I believe I'm sending the Grand Theft Auto in as well. That's not going to be a high value item or anything. But it'll be some money back at least. And the others are bundled up on eBay. So, you know, solid bit of profit in that little bundle. I got Crash Bandicoot Platinum Edition. I got this for £20, and I'm lucky. I did check before. Merchants are coming in at like 46, I believe. So I could easily get 60. So yeah, happy with that one. I got Spyro 2, Gateway to Glimmer. Has that got its manual? Yeah. God, it looks. You know when the inserts don't insert in the front and then they go like further down and you think, oh god, it's not got its manual. I keep thinking that's happening, but it does have its manual. I paid £20 for that also. Similar sort of price I'll be hoping to get back, about the £60. You know, not major profit, but these are, you know, nice. They're not going to take ages to sell and they're going to flip, so happy with that. Again, another Crash Bandicoot. God, what did I pay for this one? Where's the big box? Oh yeah, showed the big box one. What did I pay for this one? Hang on. Did I say I paid £15 for that other one? Well, I paid £15 for one of the crashes and I paid £20 for the other crash. So, yeah, that's... Oh no, I said I paid £15 for that. Yeah, that's right. I paid £15 for that in a job lot. And I also paid £15 for this one on its own, basically. So, God, I'm getting confused. So, I'll go through them again, right? So, this is what happens when you buy about 100 job lots a week. I paid £15 for that. I paid £15 for that. I paid £20 for that. And I paid £20 for that. Yeah, that's right. So, those three there are going to get me £60 back each. So, £180 in total. And then that one, like, £30 to £35. So, that's right. Yeah, I'm getting confused. I'm amazed that I've not got even more confused with the amount of stuff. So, yeah. I showed you the NES, yeah? I showed you the NES, I think. So, yeah. That's everything. As I say, I've got a few more bits and bobs upstairs. I'll just quickly go over a few of the other items I've got going out. I've got another copy of Spyro the Dragon, but it was the normal version. Not the normal version, like the first version, Spyro the Dragon, not Spyro the Dragon 2. I've got two copies of Abe's Odyssey. I've got Croc, I've got Croc 2. I've got Silent Hill, I've got Tekken 2 Big Box. I've got another PS1 console, PS2 Slim, a Mega Drive, a Wii. Now, some of those things you'll have already seen, so that's why I didn't include them. And I've got a few more bits and bobs of new and sealed stuff that I decided not to share. So, yeah. Anyway, I will finish it there, guys. I hope you took something useful out of this video. And I'm sorry I couldn't remember some of the prices. It's just how it goes. I mean, I get so much stuff in. It is really hard to remember what I paid unless I actually go back and view an invoice or, you know, view it on the PC and that. And I did try to do that before the video, but I actually did forget to do it on quite a few items. So yeah, anyway, I'll leave it there, guys. Don't forget, Please comment, like, and subscribe. And if you haven't already, please go down below and check out my Facebook page. So I will see you in the next one, guys. Bye for now.